It's a water world, our blue planet. Life couldn't survive without it. And thanks to it, a mind-blowing diversity of creatures thrive beneath the surface. Some creatures want to keep their feet dry, but there are others that can't wait to dive in. Born to enjoy the riches underwater, they must master their body's adaptations, learn to find food, to escape danger, and above all, become expert swimmers. Whether it's in rivers, on beaches, or in the deep ocean, all must overcome the obstacles and fulfill their destiny. All are born to swim. Of all the habitats on Earth, the ocean is perhaps the most challenging. Here, salt, cold temperatures, currents, and predators can make life difficult. It's not an obvious place to want to bring up your babies, but even in these waters, generation after generation beat the odds. They have overcome the challenges to become some of the most beautiful and graceful of creatures. But any baby born to swim has a lot to learn. On a windswept beach, a grey seal mother prepares to welcome a new pup. The birth is easy. He comes packaged for the waves in a streamlined sausage shape. He's 14 kilos at birth, only a tenth of his mother's weight. She needs to get his coat clean and dry to keep him warm. It's a cold birthday. During these first moments, a close bond is formed between mother and pup. The pup's first challenge is to find his mother's teats. Her milk's like clotted cream. It contains 60% fat and will fuel the pup's growth. He'll gain 2 kilos a day. Mammals are often attentive mothers, but others can be surprising. A lump sucker, a slow-moving fish of the seabed, carefully tends its nest. Though it didn't lay the eggs. This is the father. Once the female's found a protected spot to secure the brood, she leaves him on guard. Lump suckers are coastal specialists, used to the turbulent waves. With specially modified fins, they can form a suction cup to help them grip the rocks. His suckers also make good fans, keeping oxygen-rich water moving around the eggs. He works hard to keep them clean and healthy. And he stays alert, looking for any sign of trouble. Ready to see off any trespasser who might threaten his kids. Thank you. crab is small fry. But there is no intruder this brave father won't stand up to. Even an alien invasion from another world. We are not the best swimmers, but we have learned to love the water and the strange behavior of its inhabitants. Thanks to our technology, we have been able to enter this alien world in search of new friends. Even if we do get some funny looks from the residents, the young seal seems very confused by the rubbery fins. Cold, murky seawater. Clear blue reefs. Bottomless oceans and warm, fresh water. We lap it up and enjoy some incredible encounters. And some animals seem to enjoy meeting us as much as we enjoy meeting them. The crystal clear waters of Florida are a great meeting place. But the Florida manatees have a shy cousin who lives in the dark. The waters of the Amazon are stained brown. The rainforest overhead sheds leaves which rot, and their tannins turn the water into a dark tea. At less than a meter long, the Amazonian manatee calf feels his way around with whiskery hairs and paddle-shaped arms. Unlike the stiff flippers of a whale or dolphin, the manatee limb still has joints like a human arm, so that he can pull his way through the tangle of logs and roots, or to be able to hug his mother. Like all mammals, he must breathe air every few minutes and paddles his way to the surface for a lungful. Then it's back to his mother. He needs to cling on to keep up with her. A strict vegetarian, Mum must munch through 8% of her body weight each day in leaves. The 10-kilo pup's got a long way to go. She's 25 times heavier than he is, but on a rich milk diet, he'll soon catch up. He'll stay by her side until he's about 18 months old. After that, he'll be ready to explore the Amazon River alone. The Amazon has one of the greatest diversities on Earth, and among its natural-born swimmers are some of the most weird and wonderful. The arowana fish uses its swimming fins to thrust itself from the water to hunt. While the stingray uses electron therapy on its prey. And the mata-mata turtle does his best not to move at all and lets his prey come to him, relying on the flesh growths on his shell to blend into the leaf litter. And there are a few creatures that you might think were born to swim that have carved out a niche on land. Another dedicated parent, the minuscule poison dart frog. Unlike most frogs that spawn in the water, they lay their eggs directly onto leaves to try and keep them out of reach of predators. The little ones quickly develop in their jelly-filled sacs. They are born to swim and are supplied with built-in swimming pools. But unusually for frogs, their parents stick around to keep an eye on them. And when the eggs hatch, the tadpoles are in dire need of parental assistance. So their parents offer them a piggyback, carrying them one by one on their backs into the tree canopy. They will search the forest until they find a tiny pool of water in the center of a plant. This will be the paddling pool for just one tadpole to find its feet. It feeds on insects that stray too close, and the female will even lay spare eggs into the pool that it can eat. It will live here in its personal pond until it grows legs and can explore the forest on its own. It's a small and cozy nursery, a far cry from the bleak, windswept beach that's home to our seal pup. Luckily, Mum makes a good wind block. He might not be ready to swim yet, but he's already born tailor-made for an aquatic life, with a tubby, streamlined body, large eyes to help him see in murky water, and sensitive ears that will be able to detect the presence of prey. His fingers are webbed for paddling, and his fine beard of whiskers will sense vibrations of fish when he's hunting and allow him to feel his way in murky water. Grey seals are always born in winter. As a result, the pup arrives with thick white fur. It's a good barrier against the biting winds, but it's not very waterproof. His mother has a thick layer of blubber to keep her warm at sea. Short, dense hairs make the perfect wetsuit. The pup will molt in time. For now, he is stranded, unable to put his swimming tools to the test. By contrast, his cousin, the harbour seal, is literally born ready for the waves. More gregarious than the grey seal, they breed later in the year, and their pups come water ready, with the short grey coats of their parents. It seems she can't wait to get her fins wet. Riding piggyback helps build her confidence on her first swim. With her built-in wetsuit, she's ready for the waves just hours after birth. Because she can dive with Mum, she can get a few more weeks of milk supply before having to fend for herself. There are lots of other swimmers she'll meet beneath the surface, all with their own adaptations to master their medium. The menacing form of a shark. But the seal has nothing to worry about. This is a basking shark, the second largest fish on Earth. Its giant mouth is built for eating nothing bigger than plankton. Thanks to the meter-wide gaping maw, it strains tiny creatures from the sea. It can process enough water in just 1 hour to fill two Olympic swimming pools. Like all fish, basking sharks are born to swim and have a characteristic design. A streamlined body with stiff fins and an upright tail that swings side to side to propel it along. Not a fish, the dolphin's tail does the opposite. Beating up and down, it can race along at 30 kilometers per hour or more. Dolphins have a unique tool. Their rounded head, known as a melon, focuses sound waves into intense beams. The dolphin can listen to the echo of sounds bouncing off objects, or even its prey, to build up a picture of its surroundings in the murky sea. It might even be able to see inside other organisms. So when it spots the seal, it can check him out with sound, while the seal relies more on her large eyes. She can't compete with the dolphin's speed and seems to get a little shy, heading back for a ride with her mother. The mother-baby bond can be a strong one, but before any baby arrives to wet its feet, adult swimmers must come together to breed. And sometimes, water-loving lovers go to great lengths to impress members of the opposite sex. Red-throated divers tread water to perform a romantic rumba. When a spare wheel drops in, two's company and three's competition. It ups the breeding bird's efforts, proving to the outsider that they are perfectly matched. They have demonstrated their devotion and will make good parents. Few mammals look better in water than on land, but when they are courting, otters rival the best synchronized swim team. The underwater ballet will give the female the chance to test the dog otter's fitness. Only the best will do as a father to her next cubs. Alien life forms seem to occupy the deep. But even these mysterious monsters perform an elaborate deep-sea dance. Male cuttlefish tend to outnumber the females, so they arm wrestle for mating rights, flushing their skin red to white aggressively. Males raise their arms to signal they are in the romantic mood. If one lifts his tentacles at another, a fight will erupt. Looking like miniature spacecraft, without limbs, ribbon-like fins pulse to keep them hovering in place. The winner will proceed to mate. One of his tentacles is modified to transfer a packet of sperm into the female's body. He will also dislodge the sperm of any males that got there first. The female lays several hundred eggs over the next few days. She'll anchor the clusters, like black bunches of grapes, to any structure on the seabed. The male may stand guard to make sure none of the competition has the chance to dash in. It will be 2 months before the eggs hatch. Sadly, the mother won't get to welcome them. Her energy has gone into egg production. Her role is fulfilled, and she passes away. Reproducing can really take its toll on animals. And perhaps the most epic struggle takes place in northern rivers. Brown bears gather along the shore looking impatient. They are waiting for the biggest feast of the year. Eventually, their vigil comes to an end. Another batch of swimmers are on their way. The salmon have arrived. All salmon return to their place of birth in order to breed. After they hatched, these fish swam downriver and eventually out into the open ocean, where they spent up to 4 years maturing, swimming great distances to feed. But now, their maternal instincts are calling them home. The fish are put through their paces in the epic migration. Not just long-distance swimming, but having to face rapids, the chemical changes of going from salt to fresh water, and to top it off, the awaiting barrage of predators. The bears may eat 45 kilos of the protein-rich fish every day, a great boost as they build their body fat ready for hibernation. The survivors of bear attacks set about spawning, the female depositing eggs in shallow gravel nests, fertilized by the males and harassed all the while by the giant fishermen. In this world of predators, the key to survival is mass producing. Each female will lay several thousand eggs, though only a handful will live long enough to breed. After their heroic efforts, the fish are worn out. 95% will die. But it's not a complete loss. Their bodies fertilize and feed the forest and its streams, creating a productive nursery where their youngsters will spend their first few years of life. Trying to make sure your progeny survive is at the forefront of all breeding strategies. Amid the weeds, a flamboyant smooth newt is looking for love. This less dramatic female is already laying eggs one by one. Newts go to painstaking lengths to safeguard their water babies. None more so than the smooth newt's larger cousin, the great crested. The female lacks the elaborate crest. Once they've mated, the female carries both eggs and sperm into the vegetation. She painstakingly lays each egg beneath a leaf to hide it from danger. She folds the leaf and glues it in place, the perfect nursery. This individual care couldn't contrast more with that of their cousins, the frogs. Though she doesn't seem to have much say in the matter, a large female frog carries a male. They have a date. They are not the only couples out on the town tonight. There are even a few singletons trying to round up a last-minute date, even if they're females with baggage. Frogs enjoy an all-out orgy. In early spring, their hormones drive frantic mating behavior. They get so excited. There are even a few embarrassing cases of mistaken identity. The fire-bellied toad seems to have come to the wrong party. And when a common toad is hit on by one of the horny frogs, he can't get away fast enough. Once they've finally got their act together, the spawning begins. Thousands of eggs are pumped out by the females. The males, clinging to their backs, release sperm into the water, trying to make sure they are in the right place at the right time to fertilize the eggs. It's haphazard, but the huge number of eggs are designed to beat the odds. But not everyone at the sex party was on the guest list. Not born to swim, but born to eat swimmers. The bittern is a master of stealth. Amphibians are tied to the water to breed. But reptiles have evolved to live on land and have new challenges to protect their eggs. Turtles bury their clutch in sand to keep them away from predators. The youngsters must dig their way to the surface and make a dash to the safety of water. Their legs can carry them from birth, but they are really designed for use beneath the surface. The soft-shelled turtle uses the same technique, but unfortunately, even being underground isn't enough to keep her eggs safe. A raccoon dog is on the prowl. This cunning fox can pick up the faint scent of a Chinese soft-shelled turtle's egg stash. For the survivors of the raid, a marathon begins. This baby could fit in a matchbox, but she's born to swim. To stand any chance of survival, she must make it to water. Danger lurks in the sand. This naive young turtle is looking for a spot to sunbathe, but she's being watched. A hungry adult turtle doesn't think twice about turning to cannibalism. But with the beast busy, our hatchling makes it to the shallows. This is the first time she's ever been in the water, but instinct kicks in. Born to swim, she knows exactly what to do. First, she seeks cover. There are many predators in the water who are bigger than she is. Dense lilies may offer some protection, as well as a source of prey, for she is a pint-sized predator herself and must find food. She strikes it lucky. Carrion. A free meal never goes amiss. She's not the only one hunting. A snakehead fish. Luckily, our turtle isn't just born to swim. She's born to dig as well. There are some babies that are not born onto land, but not born onto water either. Despite freezing temperatures, a ringed seal is born directly onto the ice. The thick white fur, known as lanugu, will keep her warm, thinning out as she gets older to look more like her sleek mother. But she has more to worry about than cold feet. Polar bears are the biggest land predators, and they dine almost exclusively on blubber-rich seals. Though only a few days old, the pup has an instinct for survival. Holes in the ice are their only chance. Around 30% of harp seal babies don't survive their first year. But so far, this youngster is doing well. While a lot of the water here is frozen and seemingly uninhabitable, the long days of summer make the Arctic a popular destination for our aquanauts. Swimmers of all shapes and sizes team beneath the ice. There are even a few giants, like the slow-moving Greenland shark. But while it can slowly explore the seabed looking for carrion, others must actively seek out their food. Beluga are one of the most northerly of whales. They're white, rotund bodies are wrapped in thick blubber that keeps out the cold. Calves really must swim from birth, delivered tail first into the frigid seas. Like all mammals, they need air and must surface every few minutes to breathe. Though to begin with, the calf will be helped by his mum and the many aunts in his family pod. It might take the little one a while to master his built-in navigational equipment. Sonar, that works by emitting high-frequency sounds and listening to the echoes that bounce back from objects in their path. Once he's got it sorted, he'll be able to see in the dark and navigate the most murky seas. His life will be spent beneath the waves, but some of his blubbery neighbors enjoy sharing their time above and below the surface. Walruses, the heavyweight cousins of the seals, live around the Arctic, forming pods that can number in the thousands. Though they enjoy resting on beaches, they are most at home in the water and can dive to 80 meters and hold their breath for half an hour to forage for shellfish on the seabed. They are cautious when they come ashore, and for good reason. They are not the only large marine predator. When summer melts the sea ice, even the polar bear is forced to swim. It's not a problem, though. Polar bears are often considered marine mammals and can easily swim for days, covering 50 kilometers or more. They might be the biggest land predators with immense power, but their success on a walrus hunt is far from assured. When it's safe to do so, the walrus pod ventures ashore. The little ones, still a fraction of the 2-ton bull's weight, wisely try to stick to quieter corners of the beach. Eventually, tranquility descends, though it might be hard to sleep. In the Arctic summer, the sun never sets, but it's this 24-hour light that makes for such rich waters. Our grey seal pup has a much easier life. On temperate shores, there are no sharks or polar bears to deal with. His biggest threat is other seals. His mother returns from a fishing trip to top up his tank. But having her around can be a mixed blessing. Rowdy bulls have come ashore to breed. They have their eyes on his mother, and they are not afraid to fight for access. When the heavyweights have at it, Mum ushers her pup away. She doesn't want him crushed by 300 kilo battling bulls. Thank you. The victor goes to claim his prize. The pup is just 3 weeks old, but mother's ready to move on. Once she's mated, she'll return to the sea. Still not ready to swim, the pup's on his own. He faces several long, lonely and hungry weeks on the beach, waiting for his new fur coat and the chance to find some food. Ultimately, hunger will be his greatest incentive. It's not always a good idea to enter the water. In the rivers of the Amazon, anyone might think twice. Caiman are 2-meter crocodiles that hunt the fish and other creatures of the Amazon. The world's biggest rodents, Labrador-sized capybaras, are also born to swim, with their eyes and nostrils placed high on their heads. Basking on the beach will give them a break from the threat of caiman attacks. However, as the youngsters play, they are being watched. Capybaras don't have many defenses. The best way to remain safe is to stay in groups, where there is always a pair of eyes looking for danger. The youngsters will learn the different calls used to alert the group. A mother picks up a scent. Top predator of the jungle, the jaguar. But diving for cover in the water isn't always a good idea. This time, the caiman settles for a large catfish. With 9 kilos of crushing pressure and dagger-like teeth, the fish didn't stand a chance. As night falls, more natural-born swimmers emerge, watched over by their protective mother. She buried around 40 eggs in vegetation to keep them warm. The temperature affects the sex of her young, and this time it was cooler. All of the babies are males. There may be 40 brothers in the clutch, all born ready to hunt. Though rather than the large prey of their mother, the hatchlings will eat insects and shellfish. Miniature monsters, they are born to swim and hunt, with deep tails to propel them through the water. Ears, eyes, and nostrils placed so the rest of the baby can stay hidden beneath the surface. He already has a mouthful of sharp teeth. Despite his fearsome appearance, he's at risk of attack from his larger cousins. Time to go back to mum. Their mother will watch over them for around 4 months, until they are big enough to take care of themselves. The Amazon rainforest lives up to its name. During the height of the wet season, the rivers swell to engulf the forest. Aquatic animals of the Amazon River suddenly become residents of the trees and can swim through the canopy. Not all creatures are so thrilled. Not every animal is cut out for a life in water, and around the globe, floods wreak havoc. Not just for animals, but us too. As water levels rise, creatures are displaced. And of course, what comes up must go down. Water levels will recede, and in some cases, dry out altogether. Fish that had enjoyed more space are now left high and dry. A fish out of water is easy pickings for predators. When a young shoal is pinned against the beach by a huge snakehead, it's an opportunity that's too good for the softshell turtle to miss. Strictly carnivores, the softshells are usually ambush predators. It's all a question of timing and a lightning-fast strike. With a snake-like body, almost a meter long, the snakehead can thrust himself mouth first at his prey. And beaching is not a problem. With modified gills, he can extract oxygen from the air. It's a fish-eat-fish world, but even the hunters can become the hunted. As the months pass, our young seal is doing well. He finally has his adult fur and puts it to good use. He meets another swimmer. All over the world, there are creatures born to swim. And we seem determined to join them. Perhaps we are envious of their grace. It seems we are all water babies at heart.